good to go in September?
Yep, everybody's good to go. You know, minor bumps and bruises, but everybody's good to go.
Curious, you had a lineup with Durant at the five. I know it wasn't a lot of possessions, but he was out there, and Davis was big for them and stuck with it. Why do you like that look with Durant at the five?
Yeah, just like having flexibility. You know, having a little bit of a hybrid identity is something that, you know, I hope to achieve. I don't know if we have the exact personnel to do it. You know, my Indiana teams were big 100% of the time. You know, my Lakers teams where AD played half the time at the four, half at the five. You know, we'll mostly be, our team I anticipate will be mostly, you know, playing with a true center. But, you know, there's times throughout the course of an 82-game season where, you know, a small lineup is required, and we want to take a look at it.
One other thing I have is when you go back and watch the film with the guys, what are things that you're like, okay, maybe that was better than what I thought, and then maybe that was not as good as I thought it was when I was actually watching last night's game. Watching film from last night.
Overall or with that
lineup? Overall.
Well, I like that we kept the Lakers out of transition and we kept them off the glass. Like, if you can dominate your transition defense and limit them to one shot, even if your half-court offense is mediocre, you're still going to, you know, have an elite defensive rating that's going to give you a great chance to win. And, you know, the board differential, I think, you know, allowed us to have, I think, 17 more shots than they did. And that's something that, you know, that we want to highlight.
Nas had one of his more confident offensive games, and obviously a very physical, lengthy defender. Just what stood out to you about his game so far?
Yeah, I mean, he's more than capable offensively. You know, knocked down a shot when he went under a screen. He's a confident catch and shoot player from 3-point range, and plays extremely hard offensively. So the cutting, crashing, and all those types of things are good. And we know he's an exceptional, tough-minded defender. You know, so a really strong two-way player. It's going to help us this year.
We saw Keon get some first half minutes as well. What did you see from him this time?
Yeah, I just like, you know, he's got the ability, I think, to be an elite guard defender. You know, his ability to fly around, you know, his quickness, his recovery speed, athleticism. You saw the one block he had on the kid that was coming to the basket, but working to contain and just really gets all the way up to the backboard to contest and block the shot. You know, obviously he would need the time, you know, in the structure of our system to get all the nuances down. But, you know, I think he has exceptional defensive talent, and he can play the other side as well. So, you know, I'm high on him.
When Eric was signed, a lot of the reaction, like, there's another shooter. When Grayson got here, there's another shooter. But we've seen what those two provide for you guys in terms of rim pressure already. Just how have you liked that added element to the game where it's not just going to be those three guys providing that to your team?
I mean, it's those three guys can all attack and can all play off the basketball, but I also bring great gravity, you know, so you have to have guys that can take advantage of that, you know, in whatever way that we're talking about, whether it's our rolling bigs or, like you said, Grayson and Eric being able to penetrate the pressure on the rim and take advantage of that space, and if there's an overcommitment, you know, be able to spray it out to those guys. So those guys have been really good.
Yuta is another one where you guys have not been afraid to let him get off the dribble for a couple bounces and going to a pull-up jumper, excuse me. Just the confidence level you have in him in that part of his game.
Yeah, he's a great offensive player, you know, and he's a heady defensive player. You know, gives great effort and is always in the right spot. You know, had our, you know, our highlight play of the defensive film this morning was one of his early low man helps on the LeBron post up. It's something we had highlighted early that morning, you know, about you know, how we wanted to guard and give low man protection on post ups. You know, so he follows everything we're asking him to do literally, and you know, like you said, you know, shooting the ball off the bounce is something he's capable of as well.
Coach, how good was it to see the bench there in that second half when they left their starters in to start the second half and they went on a big run to finish the game throughout the whole entire season?
Yeah, I mean, I was just excited about the level that they played at. You know, we had a really lengthy ball containment segment of our defensive film, with 9 or 10, you know, straight clips of just guys working to move and keep their own guy in front of them. And I think that group in the third quarter, you know, really had a bunch of those. you know, it's look, it's a preseason game. You know, their starters come out against our reserves. You know, there's always going to be that kind of dip in emotion. So I'm not going to overreact to that. But I like how our guys competed. You know, I was very happy with them.
Frank, how did you feel like you guys did against the AD matchup, and what did you learn about your team just playing against a player?
Yeah, it's a lot easier coaching him than coaching against him. I can tell you that. He's a handful, you know, and it was actually a great preseason game for us because D'Lo and Austin and LeBron as handlers with AD rolling the basket, you know, that's as tough a cover as you're going to get. So they beat us a bunch of times, and that, you know, when you get beat like that, that forces us to tighten screws on our coverages, you know, and how we're going to try to limit guys like that. So it was a good test for us.
To you, is he sort of the archetype right now for what defensive bigs in like the next 10 years have to be and what they have to master with the way the game is changing?
Say that again.
Is he sort of the archetype to you with the modern NBA defensively as like an anchor and a five with all the responsibilities that they have to have with how the game is changing?
AD?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he's pretty ideal at the center position in modern NBA.
Seen a clip of or somebody talking about LeBron having to, you know, out-coach a coach. And obviously, he worked with you, you know, when you were there in L.A. How does it feel going up against a guy who's trying to out-coach you and you're basically trying to outsmart him in that sense?
Yeah, well, I did it for years in Indiana. And, you know, that was it's always a challenge, you know, when you have that level of an IQ player out there. You know, I enjoyed it when I was with him, and now it's time to go against him again. As good as there is, maybe has ever been, in terms of you know, trying to compete, you know, from an intelligence standpoint with the opposing coach.
When you look at just this season and you coach a championship team, going into this, do you go into it, okay, we should win a championship, we're going to compete for one? How do you have that mindset? What kind of mindset?
I think we have the ability to, and you know, we have to, you know, how our cohesiveness comes together, how healthy we remain, you know, how much work we put in, how unselfish we are, how committed to we are to the defensive side of the ball. Like, all of those factors, you know, will dictate whether we are able to win it or not, you know. But I don't look like it like, you know, we should or this and that. Like, a lot of things have to line up, you know, for you to get that gold ball. And but, you know, there's always a starting point of where you're at. And I like our starting point as well, you know, as well or better than anybody in the NBA.
Thanks, Coach. Thank you, Coach.